the Lightroom library, I click on my selected image and open in the development module. On the histogram, I move the graph around to make sure that I have a flat image with no clipping. You can also use the sliders, but I find working in the graph more intuitive and easier to see what I'm doing immediately. So I now select the daylight option in the white balance menu. I apply a small adjustment using the clarity and vibrance sliders. Subtlety here is the key thing. I then sharpen the image using the landscape preset. I find that this works well for the camera and lens that I use. Enlarging the image, I look for chromatic aberration, and when I find it, remove it by clicking the box in the lens corrections section. Happy, I then export the image to Photoshop. I choose to let Lightroom render the image because my version of Photoshop does not support my camera's RAW files. I check the horizons are level using the guides, and then using the Nixoft plugin Define, I remove any noise. Now this depends upon the camera, the ISO and the length of exposure, so not all images need this stage. Because I began photography using film, I still think in terms of film emulsions, and so I use alien skin exposure to emulate my favourite film stocks. In this case, Kodachrome 25. Using Nixoft's Color Effects Pro, I bring up some of the detail and also use a polarizing filter effect. Now when shooting, I didn't use a polarizing filter, as they only work when the lens is at 90 degrees to the light source. Here I was shooting into the sun. This just increases the saturation and tones down some of the specular highlights. It does not remove reflections or eliminate glare totally. I apply an adjustment curve and a levels adjustment, both in layers. I just make minor tweaks and we'll come back to this later on. I can then check what I've done by either using the history brush dialog box or just deselecting the active layer and then switching it back on to compare the two. I want to remove the glare spots caused by shooting into the light with multiple filters, so I duplicate the color effects layer and rename it retouching layer. I then use the patch tool to remove the problem areas. happy, I then move on to the next problem, which is a boat ramp across the rocks. I could clone it out, but I decide to burn it in so it becomes less noticeable. I do this in layers, and then, using my brush tool at 25% opacity, just work on the offending areas. Again, I check my progress by activating and deactivating the layer. I now go back to the levels and curves adjustment layers and tweak them again. Next stage is to adjust the colours, namely the orange lichen on the rocks and the colour of the sky. I use the hue and saturation tool in the adjustment layers and make my changes just to the yellows, reds and magenta. The key thing here is to make just small adjustments. Do anything too rash and you can introduce banding, and this is particularly noticeable in areas of uniform colour such as the sky. still not happy with the sky, particularly above the headland, so I apply a gradient on an adjustment layer. You can choose the strength of the gradient much like you use a neutral graduated filter when taking a picture. Once you're happy with the density, adjust the sliders as to where the opacity starts and stops and how the gradient blends. Gradient looks a bit dull, so I'll change the blending mode to overlay. It caused some banding, surprise surprise, so I'll turn it down by changing the opacity to 50%. The problem is my gradient now overlaps the headland and darkens it. So I'll just paint out that area on my gradient layer and bring up the shadow detail again. Finally, I want to boost the detail in the foreground rocks. I'll do this using the high pass filter as a layer mask. This just boosts the edge contrast and makes things look a little sharper. I choose to flatten and save because I've still got the unaltered DNG in Lightroom. Back in Lightroom, I color code the image. Green is good to go. It makes finding my images a lot easier. Go back into the library module, add the tags, captions, and the title. Thank you. I then go to the Maps section of Lightroom and apply the GPS coordinates. Back in the Library module, I can now compare the DNG with the finished image and see how far